Welcome to the online class. Today's topic is Earth Moments and Seasons. In this, now we will discuss about the temperature bells. What is that? Temperature bells. Rotation and revolution. The causes of rotation and revolution. Days and nights are caused by rotation. Seasons are caused by revolution. Again, I am repeating. How many movements are there for Earth? Two. They are rotation and revolution. Days and nights are caused by rotation, and seasons are caused by Earth revolution. Then, seasons. Seasons are caused by Earth's revolution. And the season, the temperature receiving, they are different from, that means they also differ. On this Earth, the sun's heat, we are not receiving equally throughout the Earth because of the curvature of the Earth. How is the Earth? The Earth in the poles, it is flattened, and in the center, it is bulbous. Okay, then what happened here in this Earth? Try to observe this. What is this? Globe or Earth, we call just like this. North Pole, South Pole. It is a 0 degree, it is an equator. Then it is 28.5 degree north than Tropic of Cancer. It is 66.5 degrees Celsius north than it is a Arctic Circle. Whereas 23.5 degrees south, we call it as a Tropic of Capricorn, and 66.5 degrees south, we call it as a Antarctic Circle. Whereas South Pole and North Pole, 90 degree S and 90 degree N. These are the some of the latitudes names we have. Okay, in this you will see, here might be if the sun is like this, at the time of the revolution and the rotation, sometimes the sun rays fall directly on the equator, and sometimes when the sun rays fall directly on the equator, that means what happens when it moves to the longer latitudes, the angle will be formed. It will follow some angle. That means what happened? The sun rays, where the sun rays are falling straightly, there they will receive more heat. When slanting rays receive less heat. When the sun rays fall directly, the places, that areas are hot and they are receiving more heat, no? That's why they are very hotter region, and the areas which are receiving slanting rays, they receive less heat. They are not that much warm, just like this. This also may not constant. It is also different from time to time because of its rotation and revolution. In this answer, we will by this, at the time of revolution and the rotation, we observe three changes based upon this latitudes. They are Tropic of Cancer to the Tropic of Capricorn. Whatever the zone is there, that we call it as a tropical belt. Tropical zone or tropical belt. Tropical zone or tropical belt. On both sides, that means 23.5 degree north to the 23.5 degree south, it will be treated as a tropical belt. Generally, this zone only we call it as a equatorial region. equatorial region because it is on the both sides of the equator. The next one, 23.5 degree to 66.5 degree in both sides. In both sides, it will treat it as a temperate belt. What is that? Temperate belt, not temperature. Temperate belt. And whereas here 66.5 degree to South Pole, and whereas 66.5 degree north to 90 degree N or North Pole, they will come under polar zone or polar belt. We call it as a polar zone or polar belt. The temperatures are different from zone to zone. Zone to zone. This tropical belt receives more heat because of sun rays falls directly in this zone. That's why. And one more, in some of the some days in the year, some days in the year, the sun rays falls directly over equator. Directly over equator. That's why what happened throughout the world, the day and night are equal. Day and night are equal throughout the world. Throughout the world. That means in the March 21st, the sun rays pass directly over the equator. Then, that means day and night are equal throughout the world. And we should identify one point. Throughout the world, days and nights are also not equal. Generally, we will say 12 hours night and 12 hours daytime and 12 hours night time. It's not a correct thing. Only on March 21, when the sun rays falls on equator, at the time only days and nights are equal throughout the world. On March 21, the sun rays falls directly over equator. Then what will happen slowly? The earth is rotating now and revolving now. At the time, what will happen? The sun rays falls over Tropic of Cancer. It falls over Tropic of Cancer on June 21st. Then, in which zone it is? It is in Northern Hemisphere. So, it is the longest day in the Northern Hemisphere. It is the longest day in the Northern Hemisphere. Okay, and then again it moves this side, south side. After this June 21, again it starts moving back. It comes again in the month of September 23rd on the equator. That means again on September 23rd the sun rays falls on the equator. It moves again. Then what? In December 21 or 22, at the time the sun rays falls on Tropic of Capricorn. On Tropic of Capricorn. It is on the equator. It is on Tropic of Cancer. Equator, Tropic of Capricorn. These 2 days, the day and nights are equal throughout the world. That's why we call these two numbers as equinoxes. What do we call? Equinoxes. And in June 21st, it is the longest day in the Northern Hemisphere. And whereas Tropic of Capricorn is in the Southern Hemisphere. See, when it was in December 21, 22, it is in the Southern Hemisphere. So, this is the shortest day for and longest night in Northern Hemisphere and longest day in Southern Hemisphere. That means we call it as a summer solstice, and this is a summer solstice and winter solstice. Are you able to understand? Equinoxes, summer solstice and winter solstice. And if we move to this polar zone, won't receive. It won't have day and night just like us. Through light, day and night only it will be happened there. That means sometimes light will be there, and sometimes darkness. That is only difference. They won't have any changes, season changes and also not there. Day means what? Light. It will stay for 6 months and darkness stay for 6 months. So what will happen? This is not suitable for livelihood. And when it will get a darkness, no, at the time the land will be covered with the snow. That's why the trees cannot penetrate into there. That's why we find that desert continents, desert areas, because the trees won't be there, no vegetation there. If light is also there, it won't be very hot just like us, because the sun rays fall slantingly only. They observe the sun in the horizon only. This is the condition of that polar zone. This is only earth movements and seasons. Thank you, children.